We have an update now on the burning apartment complex fire in far north Bexar County.
Let's go to Eyewitness News reporter Henry Ramos with the latest.
Aaron and Deborah, and that all defense attack from those fire crews is still happening right now. You can see that the structure of where people were living inside has collapsed, and they're hoping that fire doesn't continue to spread to buildings next to it. But a major issue right now with the conditions that we're dealing with is frozen fire hydrants. This is why you have fire trucks that keep coming in by the minute, bringing in water into really this makeshift pool, and then they're putting this water into a hose, which goes into the trucks, and then they move those trucks to put out this fire. It has been going on at least for 4 to 5 hours. Tonight I spoke to the Bettises. They live right next door. Their apartment as of right now has not been touched, and they're hoping that their home will be saved.
It's right next to
the building.
I mean, we're right on the edge of it. So, but they're prepared and they're ready to get our building if the fire keeps going. They're ready. Their engines are ready and everything. They're right in front of our apartment. And they said to prevent it, but they said they're going to try to salvage it. So,
hoping not to lose your home.
No.
Hope not.
But you know, everything happens for a reason.
And again, just to give you another look of the structural damage, and it just keeps collapsing here. Very dangerous cars that are burned. But again, what we've been told is that 130 people have been taken to a nearby shelter, Johnson High School. At this hour, in the 10 o'clock hour, we have not been told of any update of any injuries or deaths. But as the Bettises say, they are thankful that everyone at this point was able to make it out safely. Reporting in far north Bexar County, Henry Ramos, KINS 5 Eyewitness News.